A town steeped in political history, a legacy blighted by its current state. It owes Eskom more than 125 million rand. The Human Rights Commission also recently launched an investigation into the water and sanitation services provided by the municipality. And then there are the potholes. Years of complaints by residents fell on deaf ears. The residents are demanding the immediate dismissal of various municipal officials.
We are demanding for the clean and accountable governance, and corruption is rife. So that is why we have decided as the community to embark in this struggle, because we feel that as the residents, we cannot just fold our arms seeing that our town is dying. Like, look at the roads, there are potholes, corruption is rife.
We are tired. We are not going to wait any longer. Now it's time for them to vacate the offices.
The situation in Lingelihle, the local township, is even more dire. The community is crying out for any form of development.
We are unemployed, a lot of unemployed people have matric, we don't get jobs, but the people here who's employed at municipality in Kredok, they give the works to the tenders, to their family, to their friends, and we residents of Kredok, we don't benefit from anything.
Nobody from the municipality received protesters or their memorandum. Continuous attempts to solicit a reply from the mayor, Nonqedo Zonke, about the allegations leveled against her administration were unsuccessful. Lwando Nomoyi, SABC News, Kredok in the Eastern Cape.